So now that we remember what these operators do, this is actually doubling y by moving it one position to the left in binary. This is halving y, or rounding down and halving y for x. And you may recall that this percent sign is the modulus operator. So what this is saying is take x, divide it by 2, and tell me what the remainder is. If it's 1, then do this. So what does it mean for a remainder to be 1? It means that it's an odd number. So whenever x is odd, it adds y to z, then no matter what, it doubles y, halves x, and goes back to the loop and continues doing this until x is 0. So unless this is obvious to you, this may seem a little bit magical again. Why would this actually be equivalent to naive? Why would this actually be computing multiplication? Let's just make sure that it does first. Let's print Russian of, 14 comma 11. We'll run that, see what it gives us, 154. All right, so that is in fact 14 times 11. But we're gonna need to step through and try to understand why that it works out the way that it does. So if we give Russian the input 14 comma 11, it's going to assign these to x and y and start off z at 0. So let's take a look at that. Now it's going to go through the while loop. And on each iteration, it's going to check to see whether x is odd or even. And if it's odd, then it's going to add y to z. So we start off at 14, which is not odd. So what does it tell us to do? It tells us to double y and halve x. So we get down to 7, 22. So z remains 0. Now that the next time through, we see that x is odd. So we add y into z, makes it a 22. We halve x and double y. In this case, halving and rounding down. So that gets us a 3 and a 44. So the next time through the while loop, we see that x is 3, which is odd. So that tells us to add 44 into z, giving it a total of 66. Then we have x rounding down and double y. Go back up to the top of the while loop, we see x is odd again. So we add y into z. Then we have x rounding down and double y. At which point x becomes 0 and it returns the value of z, which lo and behold is 154. So it seems to have done the right thing. What we've really done here is we've added several values of y. Each of the times as x is counting down, each of the times x becomes odd, we add those together. So it ends up being the sum of those three numbers. So you have to admit that's kind of cool, right? It's somehow doing the equivalent of 14 times 11, but not the way we would normally do it.